Okay. Good day, everyone. Konnichiwa. So we are now on lesson 7. This is the grammar part. But before you dive into this video lecture, it is presumed that you have already watched and studied the vocabularies. Anyway, it's just a few minutes of your time. So punta muna kayo dun before here. Now, if you already watch it and understand the context, so it's now better to go in this grammar part. So in this one, we are going to examine the relationship of the sender and receiver. You know? So of course, we're going to construct sentences using that. So in that sense, I receive a present. So paano mo siya i-express into Japanese? So presento o moraimashita. So I receive a present or nakatanggap ako ng regalo. Okay, let's proceed. Okay, so the topic outline for this discussion or video lecture would be centering on the following pointers. So tatlo lang naman siya. It's quite very short, but I will try to highlight the most important things of this lecture now. So also, it's also advisable to balik-balikan natin mga previous lessons natin if it's not yet clear to us. Okay. So the first one would be the use of de as tool or instrument marker. So in lesson 5, we use de as the means to mark the vehicle. Lesson 6 as the means to mark the venue or the action or the place of the action. No? For this lesson 7, we use de as the to mark the means of the tool or instrument or particularly an object that we use to carry out the verb. Now, next would be giving and receiving statements. So we're going to construct such statements here. And finally, the use of mo and mada in a statements. Okay, so now let's move on. Okay, let's use de as the marker for tools, instruments. Okay, so tools and instruments, it requires an object. So it's an object that we can use to facilitate the verb. For example, bara ha hasami de kirimas. So it means to say bara, rose, hasami, scissor, kirimas is to cut. So mean to say based on that words and particularly the arrangement of the particles. So bara would be the topic because that's marked by wa. Hasami, it's marked by de. So it means to say it is the instrument or the tool that is used for what? For carrying out the verb or facilitating the verb, which is kirimas to cut. So now, in case that we have use o, particle o, okay, for this example, baba, at the bottom, sakura wa iPhone de sashin o toremas. Okay, sakura is the flower. So ito yung tinik mo ng picture. So this is the one you have taken your picture, no? It's because it's marked by wa. iPhone de, it is the means. Okay, it's the way or the instrument in carrying out the taking of the picture. And of course, sashin o torimas. Okay, it means to say that the picture. Okay, you take the picture. Not the flower, but the picture of the flower. So it's very important to distinguish the use of particle wa, de, and o. Okay? So yun po. For the first statement, let's go back again. Bara wa. Hasami de kirimas. So pag pinagpalit mo siya, it's contextually wrong because how can you cut the scissor using the roses? So it's wrong. So it's important that the object is in proper order. Okay? And of course, it's better described by the particles, no, corresponding. Next, follow. This is some sort of a review. So again, our previous statement, bara wa hasami de kirimas or the rose is cut by the scissors, or I cut the roses using the scissor. Now, in the second statement, you have the second statement here. Let me use the okay. Barawa niwa de kirimas. Okay. Barawa niwa de kirimas. So, as highlighted here, let me use the highlighter. Okay. As I lightered here, sorry for that. Okay. So you see that hasami is an object, niwa is a garden or a place. So the difference is the place. So if it's a place, it is the venue instead of the object or the instrument. Okay, so that's the main difference of the two. Okay, the first statement talks about that the roast is cut using the scissor, and the second statement is referring to the roast was caught in the garden. So it's the place of or the venue of the action. Okay, now moving forward, what about lesson 7 compared with lesson 5, which is use de as the means or the vehicle? Gakse de kaimas. Okay, gakse de kaimas. So it should be, okay, palitan natin, that's medyo wrong to, kasi gakse should be the topic, no? Of course, that's typo. So palitan natin, it should be. Okay, so dapat meron tayong instrument pa dito. Okay, gakse. Okay, so instead of gakse, siguro he was referring to the gakse. Siguro baka he was referring to the means. Okay, so siguro let's say Gcash. Gcash. Yeah. So let's move on. So Gcash tayo. Okay. Highlighter natin. Okay, that's good. So Gcash de kaimas. So ano yung ginamit pang bili or pang buy? Kaimas is to buy Gcash. So ano yung binili? So that would be part marked by particle O. For example, ang binili ko is t-shirt. T-shirt O Gcash de kaimas. Or watashi wa Gcash de t-shirt O kaimas. Diba? Ganun siya. Kasi yung binili mo is marked by particle O, which is the direct object of the verb. Now, paano siya binili is marked by particle te, which is the instrument. So it's also, of course, the question for here would be nande. For example, nande t-shirt o kaimas ka? So how did you buy the t-shirt? Or my answer would be Gcash de, or let's say venue, yung means. Let's say Shopee de t-shirt o kaimas, di ba? So pwedeng ganun. Okay, for this one is siguro Gcash yung ginamit as means of pambayad or pagbili. Okay, so yun siya. Next, gakse wa jitensya de ikimas. So si student ay sumakay ng bicycle going somewhere. Di kasi sinistate yung place, no? So, but the point here is that this one is a vehicle and this one is the means or the instrument. Now, the difference is, of course, the verb itself. So, verb. Bakit? Kasi this one is kaimas. It's not non-moving verb siya. So, meaning to say, wala siyang ini-imply na paggalaw or movement. Ikimas is a movement verb. So, meaning to say, there is implication or it implies that the object or a person was transitory or meaning to say, gumagalaw siya or nagalaw siya. Okay? In that sense, it's a movement verb. So, the difference is, of course, we assume that jitensya de is the vehicle. It's logically because that's a bicycle. Okay, so let's move forward. Okay, for subtopic number 2, which is giving and creating receiving statements. No, so giving and receiving statement. I want you to recap again the vocabulary. So vocabulary natin, there are giving verbs. So it's an invention of mine para mas madali tayo mag-facilitate ng ating learning. So pag giving verb, you must be able to internalize that the particle wa marks the sender. The particle ni marks the receiver. Okay. Huwag natin siya pagbabalik ta rin kasi it will be a disaster for you. Okay. So let's have it. Okay. Again, topic is the sender. Okay, because that's the main star. Kumbaga sa ano, artista, pag may topic marker or may topic marker kan particle wa or wa, it's the topic. So meaning to say that's the main star. Siya yung pinag-uusapan sa statement. Siya yung main actor. Now, of course, makakakita ka ng person number 2 or another person, that would be the supporting character or kumbaga sa movie, supporting actor. Hindi naman pwedeng yung supporting actor siya yung naging bida, di ba? So dapat yung main actor yung palaging bida. Kaya ang particle wa nando doon. Particle ni kaya nando doon para to mark that this guy is the supporting. Kumbaga sa ano siya, importante siya in a sense kasi kung wala siya, wala, hindi mabubuo yung sentence or hindi mabubuo yung storya. Pero syempre, ang pinakabida nga or the highlight will be given to the person with particle wa. Okay? So ganun ang analogy natin dito, ha? Yan. Okay, let's move forward. Okay. So example, watashi wa sensei ni report o agemasu. So sino nagbigay? So ikaw, kasi ikaw ang may topic wa or watashi. Ako, ako daw yung nagbigay kasi ako yung topic eh. Ako yung may mark ng particle wa or ikaw yung, kumbaga sa ano, ikaw yung may marker or may corona ng wa, di ba? Now, sino yung pinagbigyan mo? Receiver eh. Sensei. Kasi pag binaligtad mo siya, si teacher, binigyan ka ng report. Okay. So parang ganun ang storya, which is hindi yun ang totoong storya, di ba? Nag-send ka ng report sa teacher. So, watashi wa sensei ni reporto o agemasu. Di ba? Ganun siya. Next. Now, dito naman sa second statement ko, pwede naman natin i-drop off or parang i-ano na natin. No? Parang kasi ang practice kasi sa Japan, pag alam mo na yung topic, omitted na siya. Hindi na drop off na siya. For example, this sense, kasi kung nagsasalita, so I assume na, or ako nagsasalita, ina-assume na ng tao referring to myself or referring to me. Tomodachi ni tegami o kakimasu. O kakimasu, which is to write. Now, kakimasu is, of course, nagsusulat ka. Of course, that it implies that it's some, though it's lesson, hindi siya lesson 7 na verb, no? Lesson 6 siya, pero it implies a direction pa rin. Okay? Kakimasu eh. Okay. So, ano yung binigay? Tagami. Ano yung, or if we ask the question, tomodachi ni nani o kakimasu ka, what did you write? Okay. So, that's tagami, letter. So, to whom did you write? Dare ni tegami o kakimasu ka? So to whom do you write? Or para kanino yan? The answer is tomodachi ni. Diba? Tomodachi ni tegami o kakimasu. Ngayon, sino sumulat? Eh, ako yung nagsasalita, diba? So the answer would be Argel-san. Argel-san wa tomodachi ni tegami o kakimasu. Diba? Ganun siya. So, importante yung mga role na yan. Yung particle, importante siya sa buhay ng Japanese language kasi it marks the relationship. So, dito natin nakikita yung grammar talaga. Ano yung binigay, sino binigyan, at sino yung nagbigay, diba? Or sino nagpadala, or nag-send. Okay? So, ngayon, sa second naman, inverse to, no? Baliktad. Kung sino yung topic holder or parang holder or mark na ma-mark ng particle wa, siya yung receiver. Kung sino niya may nakani, siya po ang sender. So, using the same sentence kanina, okay? So, using the same sentence kanina, i-revert lang natin siya. Okay? Remember nyo, topic nyo dito, kasi receiving verb siya, kung sino yung wa, siya yung receiver. Kasi yung verb mo is a receiving verb. Ngayon, kung sino yung ni, siya yung sender. Which is the total opposite naman kanina, di ba? Kanina kasi, ang verb mo kasi is giving. So kung giving verb siya, kung sino yung giving, giver, siya yung main star. Kung sino yung receiver, supporting star siya. Kasi nga verb mo, giving, di ba? So example, yan. First statement mo is watashi wa sensei ni reporto o agemasu. Okay? Klaro yan. Ako binigyan si teacher ng report. Ganon. Now, dito naman, dahil receiving verb ka, ang bida dito, of course, receiver. Supporting kas lang sender, ha? Kasi supporting kas siya. Hindi naman sending verb to. Or hindi naman siya giving verb, di ba? So, ito siya. Balikta rin natin. So, ganun ang relationship, ha? So, kanina. Di ba? Kanina is, watashi wa sensei ni reporto o agemasu. So, I give my report to the teacher. Dito naman baliktad. Kasi mas importante na yung receiver. Okay. Sensei wa watashi ni reporto o moraimasu. Moraimasu. Okay. Again, sensei wa watashi ni reporto o moraimasu. Moraimasu. Okay. The teacher received the report or the teacher received the report from mine or the teacher the teacher received my report. Okay, ganun siya. Kasi moraimasu, dictionary form. Moraimasu is to receive. Okay, nakuha. Next, yung kanina statement. Binaliktad lang natin to ha. Tomodachi ni tegami o moraimashita. So the friend, siya yung nag-sender, no? So baliktad. Kasi di ba yung marker mo dito is particle ni. So siya yung sender ngayon, this time. Okay. Or baka he was referring now to, kasi di ba tomodachi. So maaring the other party nagsasalita dito. Okay. Tomodachi ni tegami o moraimashita. Na-receive na yung kanyang letter or na-receive yung letter from a friend. Ganon. Now, if we are replying to the previous statement, okay. Halimbawa, ikaw pa rin nagsasalita. Let's say me, ako nagsasalita nito. Tomodachi ni tegami o kakimasu, I write a letter to my friend. So ngayon, let's say, sasabihin ko kung na-receive niya na yung letter ko. So kasi particle ni na gamit dito, siya yung sender. So meaning to say, perspective ng kaibigan ko yon. Ngayon, dahil ako na nagsasalita, tomodachi wa tegami o moraimashita. Receive. Was received by my friend. Diba? So ganun siya. Okay, so of course, tignan nyo maigi yung perspective. Okay, so doon tayo nagkakatalo-talo ha. So dito, kasi tomodachi yung ginamit. So either ako or yung kaibigan ko ngayon dito, nagsasalita siya from his perspective. Ngayon ko ako magsasalita from my perspective dahil ako yung sender kanina, gagamitin ko is tomodachi wa tegami o moraimashita. Okay, from my perspective ha. Kasi ako yung nagpadala ng letter eh. Dito naman, siya yung nakatanggap. Or I mean, siya yung parang ano eh. Parang siya yung, tawag dito? Nakatanggap. So yung letter daw galing sa kaibigan niya. Okay? So yun siya. Last but not the least importante po ito is already, mo. Example. Mojigan desho, so it means to say it's already time. So meaning to say maririnig niyo siya sa mga exam. Mojigan desho, so it's already time. So tapos na, o diba? Or parang conversation like this. Tabemashita ka? Tabemashita ka? Kumain ka na ba? Or did you eat? Hai, mo tabemashita. Hai, yes. Already, tabemashita, eaten, or ate, or I already ate. Diba? Ganun siya. Okay? Siyempre, ang Japanese, baka maano tayo sa grammar nila. Ang grammar natin sa English is three tense siya. Future, past, saka present. Sa kanila, non-past, saka ano lang, diba? Past. Okay. Ito naman, mada. Means to say not yet. So, meaning to say it's a ongoing action. Kasi mada is not yet. So, mark niya is ongoing or an action being completed pala. Example, tabemashita ka? So, kumain ka na ba? Or do you eat? Iye? Mada des. So, it means to say, no, not yet. Okay, ganun siya, no? Now, never tayo nasagot na ganito. Iye? Mada tabemasen deshita. Kasi bakit? Again, mada des or mada is an action ongoing. There is a presumption that the action is ongoing. So how can you assume certain action if it's a negative tapos past form pa? So hindi po natin siya pinagawang ganon. So it's safe to answer iye mada des. Okay. Or iye na lang. Tapos mada des. Okay. Ngayon, paano kung mada tabemasen? Not yet. Okay, that is also wrong, 'di ba? Kasi parang not yet eaten or not yet tapos negative action, di ba? Parang ganun siya. So mas better kasi contextually alam naman ng tinatanong kung ano yung action ay nahanap. So you can answer iye mada des na lang. So para mas ano tayo. Okay? So now if you have some questions, feel free to ask question in the comment box. And if you like this video, it's quite short lang naman because we are already advanced in this stage. So mas mabilis tayo. And if you know someone who could study in Japanese as well, so you might share and of course subscribe. Thank you very much. Arigato gozaimasu. Gambaremasu.